Kevin here. Everyone has War God. And it's kind of an installment of the Vinyl Hunter, but it's also record store day purchases. And I was out yesterday. I didn't go early in the morning for the crowds. I just don't want to stand in line for hours. So I kind of went in later on towards noon. And I got almost everything I was looking for. There were a couple items that either they didn't get or they were out. But anyway, I'm going to start off with what I got for record store day. And first up is Jimi Hendrix Experience. 7-inch, it's in mono, Burning of the Midnight Lamp. And this has Crosstown Traffic and Gypsy Eyes. I have number 3,663. I'm not sure how many are being issued. If I were to guess, I'd say probably 5,000 or 10,000, but I picked up this. So I am not a real big, huge Hendrix fan, but I'm probably going to be giving this to someone, so I just picked it up just to have it. So anyway, Jimi Hendrix. Up next, an item I went for, and which is the 35th anniversary of Holy Diver, recorded live in 83. On 10-inch. I did specifically want this. A couple places I stopped. One place had it. One place didn't. Actually, I stopped at three places. Two of the three had this, so I picked it up. Not a bad price. But see the back. The front. Next one I wanted to get, I actually kind of got lucky on this one. This is the only one that was left at Orange Records. And talking about Blue Cheer and the 67 demos. Now this is only recorded on one side. It's the 67 Procreation at Berg Heavy Metal. Came from Airwaves in KSAM in San Francisco. Like I say, it's only recorded on one side. The second side kind of has a intro to Buying the First Album. But anyway, I like what I heard on the first side, but my opinion, the price is too much for only being one-sided album. While it's not a very bad recording, I like it. Just wasn't worth the price. So anyway, some Blue Cheer. Up next, this is something I really wasn't gonna get, but I did anyway. And I'm talking about Joan Jett and Bad Reputation. I heard this, it's fantastic. Great. Some of the hits, some of the early stuff from the Runaways is on this. And it has, let's see, it is yellow vinyl, transparent yellow. That stuff from Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, the Runaways, Bikini Kill, and previously unreleased track with Joan Jett, Miley Cyrus, and Laura Jane, Grace Up Against Me. But well worth the price, I think. I got this, actually, they listed it at 20, and while the place didn't sell any, he dropped the price by $3. So I picked it up, and yeah, I like what I heard on this, I'm glad I picked this up. Up next, another one I wanted to get, and I'm glad I did get it. I've heard this. It's a great, great release. There have been comments on YouTube about it should be remixed, but you know, for how raw it is, I think it sounds pretty good. And I'm talking about Iggy and the Stooges and Raw Power, which is celebrate the 45th anniversary with the rarest and the rawest deep cuts. This is officially the first time it's released on LP. It has alternates and outtakes from Raw Power, one of the greatest rock albums of all time, and well worth the price. Sometimes these can be very overly priced, but in this case, I think it was appropriate. Some may disagree, but anyway, I'm glad I picked this song. Very good album. Anyway, so I was at a couple shops, and picked up some vinyl that I seen that was posted on the Vinyl Giants website a couple weeks ago, and I didn't think these would be here. Well, the cover of this isn't in very, very good shape. The album is in very good shape, and I'm talking about docking. Tooth and nail, of course, is really bad right here. But the vinyl is in good condition. I'll look for a different cover. But here's one of them I picked up. And then I picked up Under Lock and Key. This has water damage down here. The back cover has the front cover from the previous album I showed you on the back here. But vinyl's in great shape. Anyway, here's some docking Under Lock and Key. And these are specifically what I wanted to get, and they were there. Surprise me. Felix out of Canada. I picked up, this is A Long Way to Heaven. I think this is my third or fourth Felix on vinyl. Covers are in okay shape. Probably good to VG. Vinyl's in VG Plus. But I was just happy to pick this up. And then I picked up Walking the Razor's Edge from Helix. Cover's in good shape, VG, VG Plus. Vinyl's VG, VG Plus. I cleaned these and they look very good now. But anyway, here's the second Helix I picked up. Never really see this at the shops I go to. And then I wasn't really looking for this. This was there in that mix that I just showed you, talking about Keel and a self-titled album here. Again, covers VG, VG Plus, vinyls in VG, VG Plus. But just happy to pick up some Keel. And I couldn't remember if I had this or not. I picked it up anyway. Picked up Blue Oyster Cult Mirrors. And it's got a little bit of ring wear. But the vinyl is in VG, VG Plus. So it's very good shape. But I'm happy to pick this up. And then I wasn't going to get this, but the cover is in good shape. I pulled out the vinyl, it looked pretty good. I have two others. One is beat up, it's no good. Second one I have, the cover is beat up. So I picked this up anyway. I'm talking about Angel's self-titled debut, which is a very, very good album. And highly recommend this. The Tower being my favorite track off of this. The whole album is very good, but Tower is one of my favorites. And anyway, so I picked this up. And then I got three more. I stopped in at the Orange Records. I was there once, went through stuff, I left, and I came back. I didn't see this when I initially went through the used, but I picked up this from Litterer and Rock This City. The guy said he found it in South Dakota. and I believe the band was out of South Dakota or Iowa, so I picked it up and anxious to hear this. This came out, let's see, 1987, so here's some literary. And I never see this, I had to have it. I'm a huge fan, I got to have all their stuff. Slowly but surely, I am trying to acquire it all. So I picked up this when I seen it. Status Quo, 12 volt bars. Basically, 12 of their best hits from various albums. This was originally released in, let's see, I'm probably not going to see it though. I can't see it on the back, but was happy to pick up this Status Quo 12 bars. And the last one, which was kind of a bargain bid, vinyl's good, cover's good, Al Di Meola and Land of the Midnight Sun. I had this, I needed it, so anyway. So that's all I have for Record Store Day Vinyl Hunting. See you next time, guys, on the Mail Update. Take care.